light and heat. In terms of fire, by the medium or the one end of electric fire, spirit and fire by friction energize matter. Fire is produced. This solar fire can be distinguished above all else by its evolutionary development and by the gradual intensification of the heat to be felt and of the light to be seen. For a clearer comprehension of this abstract matter, we might consider the microcosm of man evolving in the free world. Man is the product of the approximation at present imperfect of the temple of the spirit, the Father in heaven made matter the mother. The result of this union is an individualized Son of God, or Nunita. Divine Self, an exact replica in miniature on the lowest plane of the great Son of God, the All Self, who is in himself the totality of all the miniature suns, of all the individualized selves, and of each and every unit. The microcosm, expressed in other terms from the subjective point of view, is a miniature sun distinguished by the qualities of heat and light. Present the light is, under the bushel, or heatly emitted by a veil of matter, within. A new process of evolution is shining forth to such an extent that the veil will be lost from sight in a blaze of exceeding glory. At present the microcosmic heat is a small degree, or the magnetic radiation between the microcosmic units is the little felt. Intensification of the inner. point of view. As we know, our sun is within the fourth order and on the lowest cosmic plane. When the sun has a painful expression, that is, affecting his display of light and heat, then he will shine forth upon another plane, that of the cosmic mental. We have the analogy in the microcosm for man. When a man's light fully shines forth, when his magnetic radiation has reached the stage of vivid interaction or group activity, then he has attained full self-expression and has included within his sphere of influence and control the mental plane. He is then considered a master. He also is of the fourth order. He is the quaternary. The etheric plane is the center of his life in the physical sense. Just as we are hanging out the sun and the planets esoterically are considered not existing in etheric matter. As above, so below is the occult law. Therefore, the relationship of the son of the father and of the mother is to the son the same as man's relationship to the vehicle through which he functions. It is his mode of enterprise, his vehicle of expression, it is the form which his life animates for the specific purpose of A, B, C, D, E, gaining experience, making contact, developing full self-knowledge, achieving full mastery or control, attaining manhood, cosmic. The cosmic Christ must measure up to the stature of a full-grown man, as it is expressed in the Christian Bible 0.93f. Expanding his consciousness, 93 Bible, EP 413. INTROGUESTIONS 231. All these stages have to be achieved on a cosmic level, in exactly the same sense as the microcosm. On a systemic level, likewise strives for similar ideals. What is SEANDHOWSITEPROGRAMMING? Life cycle. I do not propose to deal here with the evolutionary process in any other way than Greeks would indicate that the whole method of evolution is simply that of adjusting the matter aspect to the spirit aspect. The former feels entirely adequate as a body of expression for the latter. The life cycle of the sun is 100 years of drama in the same sense as man has a life cycle consisting of a certain number of years dependent upon his karma. During the life cycle of a man, he expresses what is in on a particular stage, and gradually develops from the stage of the antenatal period wherein the self overshadows the matter aspect until the period wherein the higher self takes possession of the prepared form. This stage varies with every individual. From that, time our inner self-consciousness or thought, and the man is proceeding normally, expresses himself through the form ever more adequately. Each life of lesser cycle is a greater cycle of the ego or self, that expression in mortality brings the form more under control and develops a conscious realization of the self until there comes a culminating cycle that lives in which the self then rapidly dominates and takes full authority. Becomes fully adequate. The conclusion of each tip that was of spirit and matter is fully lighter fiery objectivity.
Grand man.
sun and the seven sacred planets, each of whom embodies one of his seven principles, just as he in his totality embodies one of the principles of a greater cosmic entity. B. A heavenly man. He manifests through a planet, and embodies one of the principles of the sun, the Logos. He himself is likewise developing through seven principles, which are the source of his essential unity with all other heavenly men. Cosmically considered, the sun is developing the principle of a greater cosmic being, that principle which we call love wisdom. That is the fundamental characteristic he has to develop during his life cycle. Each heavenly man, therefore, embodies predominantly a subsidiary principle of the fundamental one. In like manner, he himself has six subsidiary principles, as has the sun. C. A human being, man. He manifests on the busy. 2. Men, the monad, the units of consciousness. They, in their totality, make up the bodies of the seven heavenly men. Each monad is found upon one of the seven rays, S. E. I. 197, 285, 624, S. E. 2, 85, 176, 196.
Of form by the means of active intelligence. B.
connected solar system or the form adequate to the needs of the indwelling spirit. Here, a similar tabulation may be worked out to demonstrate the similarity of the process in the case of a heavenly man and a human being. If we ask why 10 schemes, and in effect 10 planets, 7 sacred and 3 con, 236 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. In the 7 sacred planets are eventually merged into the 3, and finally the 3 are blended into the 1. This can be traced along the line of analogy as we consider the 7 rays. And during 7 rays, which in a manifestation are diverse, are eventually synthesized. The minor core are blended, we are told, into the 3rd major ray, and the 3 major rays are finally merged into the 1 synthetic ray, and love wisdom ray, the dragon of wisdom, the occult serpent swallowing its tail. 0.95 This has been pointed out by H.P. We have, therefore, the 3 crowning rays, with 7 seen during the evolutionary process. In connection with the heavenly men, functioning through the planets, there are, therefore, 3 planets which might be considered as synthesizing planets, and 4 which are blended eventually, until the 3 have absorbed the essence of the 4, finally the 1 absorbs the essence of the 3, and the work is completed. This process lies many millennia ahead, during the inevitable period of the gradual expiration of our system. Before the heavenly men find their magnetic opposites, and fuse and blend, first this takes place between themselves, the negative and the positive rays merging and fusing, forming then the 2 from the 4. Again the 2 merge, producing a united whole, and the 1 thus produced blends with the major 3rd ray, the intelligence aspect, the ray represented in our planetary hierarchy by the Mahashoman. The fusion will proceed until ultimate unity is reached in the system, and the sun has accomplished his purpose. Perfected love wisdom, his light shines forth cosmically, his magnetic radius touches the periphery of his cosmic opposite, and the mirror is the sun of effected. The 2 cosmic units merge. If we here naturally ask which is the cosmic unit that is our solar opposite, we shall be told that that question. 95 serpent swallowing its tail.
Under new